Hello, my dear students. Myself, Purbashree Barman, and today I'm going to give you the notes of English literature of class 7, chapter 1, looking for vultures eggs. So firstly, number A, answer the questions with reference to context. Number 1, it was in one of them that he had come across this amazing piece of information. The book had a title on the cover, An Anthology of Ancient Philosophical Works. Where was this book found? Who found it? Answer, this book was found in a wooden chest which was crammed with books. Next para, Oppu found this book. Number B, what information is being spoken about here? Answer, the writer in this book was describing the properties of mercury. Full stop, if you put some mercury in a vulture's egg and leave it out for few days in the sun and then hold it in your mouth, then you would be able to fly in the sky. Next, number C, why was it amazing? Answer, it was amazing because it was the easy way to fly and yet nobody knows about it. Now question number 2. He asked her sister, comma, Didi, do you know where vultures build their nests? Number A, who was the speaker? Answer, Oppu was the speaker and he was speaking to his elder sister Durga. Number B, why was he asking about vultures? Answer, Oppu was asking about vultures because he wanted to find some eggs of vultures which will help him to fly. Number C, what did his sister say in reply? Answer, his sister Durga replied that she did not know where vultures build their nests. Number 1, describe the condition of the book that Oppu found in the wooden chest. Answer, the book had a peculiar old smell. The pages were thick and covered with dust, comma, the cover was faded and molted like marble, comma, and as he turned it back, a swarm of silver fish darted out and disappeared. Full stop. He loved the peculiar old smell, comma, there was something about it which made him think of his father. Next question, what did the boy in the village tell Oppu about the vultures? Answer, the boy told Oppu about the vulture's egg. They built their houses at the top of big trees in the open country. Number 3, how much did the cowherd want for the eggs? With what did Oppu pay him? Answer, the cowherd wanted 2 annas for getting vulture's eggs for Oppu. Next para, Oppu managed to get 2 pies from his sister and completed the deal. The cowherd boy took some of Oppu's quarries as well. Question number 4, what were the thoughts that ran through Oppu's mind after he got the eggs? Answer, initially, comma, Oppu felt delighted and full of enthusiasm. Full stop. The doubts started creeping in and he began to have doubts about whether he would be able to fly, comma, when he would fly at, comma, where he would fly to. Full stop. Question number 5 and the last question of this chapter. What happened to the eggs? What was Oppu's reaction? Answer, while Durga was removing among some torn rags, comma, the 2 eggs rolled from the back of the shelf, comma, fell on the floor and broke. Next para, Oppu cried and refused to touch his foot for a whole day. So now students, write down the questions and answers properly and nicely. Thank you everyone.